This is Janet Andrabir.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain the torsional couple and give the expression of its moment about the wire. Give the expressions of the torsional or elastic potential energy and the mechanical energy of the torsion pendulum Earth system. Determine the differential equation that governs the motion of the undamped torsion pendulum. Introduce the solution of the differential equation. Determine the expressions of the natural frequency, natural angular frequency, natural period, maximum angular speed, and maximum angular acceleration of the torsion pendulum.
Torsion pendulum. We studied before the horizontal elastic pendulum. Now, we are going to study another oscillator called torsion pendulum. To know more about this pendulum, let's watch this short experiment.
A torsion pendulum is formed by a torsion wire fixed from its upper end and connected from its lower end to a rigid body. The rigid body could be a disc, a rod, etc. In this experiment, the rigid body is a disc. When we rotate the disc by an angle theta in the horizontal plane about a vertical axis passing through the torsion wire, the torsion wire is twisted or rotated by the same angle theta. Then it exerts a restoring moment on the disc. This restoring moment tends to retain the disc to its equilibrium position as shown, and the oscillatory motion starts.
So, during the rotation of the disc, the wire or the torsion wire is twisted or deformed. Then the wire exerts on the disc a restoring torsional couple, which tends to bring the disc back to its equilibrium position. Now we can make analogy between the torsion pendulum and the horizontal elastic pendulum. In the horizontal elastic pendulum, when the spring is deformed, it exerts a restoring force on the block. This force tends to bring the block back to its equilibrium position. Similarly, in the torsion pendulum, when the torsion wire is twisted or rotated, it exerts a restoring couple on the object, tends to bring the object back to its equilibrium position.
Consider the figure. So this is the wire and this is the disc. In this example, when the radial section of the disc is in the position OO', so this is OO', we take this as an origin of angles, which means that theta is taken as zero in this position. And this is the equilibrium position of the disc. As we have seen in the previous slide, when the disc is rotated in a certain sense in the horizontal plane, the restoring couple tends to bring the disc back to its equilibrium position. Now, this is done by exerting a restoring torsional moment, which is given by this formula, m is equal to minus c theta. Now, the SI unit of the moment is Newton meter. C is the torsion constant of the wire. C depends on the length, cross-sectional area, and the substance forming the wire. Now, finally, look at minus theta m and theta m. These are the extreme positions of oscillation. Take into account that the oscillation amplitude remains constant in case of undamped oscillations and decreases with time in case of damped oscillations. So we have the moment of the restoring couple, m is equal to minus c theta. But what does theta mean? Consider the figure. So recall that OO' is the equilibrium position of the radial section of the disc. Now, when the radial section becomes in the position OA, it makes an angle of theta with the equilibrium position OO'. So theta is the angular abscissa of the disc relative to its equilibrium position, theta equal zero. Again, consider the figure. When the radial section of the disc is in the position OA, We say that the wire is twisted through an angle theta. So theta is also the twist angle. Now, what is the SI unit of theta? The SI unit of theta is the radian.
Elastic potential energy stored in a torsion wire. While twisting the wire by an angle theta from its equilibrium position, the work done by the restoring moment results in a transformation of kinetic energy in the rigid object into elastic or torsion potential energy stored in the wire. So, the elastic potential energy stored in the wire is given by this formula, EPE equal 1/2 c theta squared. We can make analogy between the elastic potential energy stored in the torsion wire and that stored in a spring. The energy or the elastic potential energy stored in a spring studied before is given by 1/2 k x squared. So c is analogous to k and theta is analogous to x. Now, expression of the mechanical energy in the system, torsion pendulum, earth. As you know, the mechanical energy is equal to the kinetic energy of the rigid object plus the elastic potential energy stored in the torsion wire plus the gravitational potential energy in the system. It's better to take the horizontal plane passing through the center of mass of the object as a reference level for gravitational potential energy. So GPE becomes always zero. Therefore, the mechanical energy in the system is equal to 1/2 I theta prime squared, which is the kinetic energy of the rigid object, plus 1/2 C theta squared, which is the elastic potential energy in the torsion wire.
Now, let's determine the differential equation that governs the free undamped oscillations of the torsion pendulum. Now, friction is neglected, or we can say that the sum of the works done by the non-conservative forces is zero. Therefore, the mechanical energy of this system is conserved. So, the time derivative of ME is equal to zero. The mechanical energy is equal to 1/2 I theta prime squared plus 1/2 C theta squared. Now, let's differentiate both sides of this equation with respect to time. So, dme by dt is equal to zero because it is constant. 1/2 I is constant, so it is the same. And the derivative of theta prime squared is equal to 2 theta prime theta double prime. Similarly, 1/2 c is constant, and the derivative of theta squared is equal to 2 theta theta prime. Now, the half and the 2 cancel out. So this is going to be 0 is equal to I theta prime theta double prime plus C theta theta prime. Take theta prime as a common factor. Now, theta prime is equal to 0, or I theta double prime plus C theta is equal to 0. But theta prime equals 0 is rejected because the angular speed of the pendulum is not always zero. It is only zero at the extreme positions. So we still have I theta double prime plus C theta equal zero divided by I. This is going to be theta double prime plus C over I theta is equal to zero. This is the second order differential equation that governs the variation of theta.
Determination of the differential equation that governs the motion of the torsion pendulum using Newton's second law for rotation. In some references, this law is called the theorem of angular momentum. In this case, we take the disk as the system. So the external forces acting on the disk are the weight of the disk mg vertically downward, the tension force exerted by the torsion wire vertically upward, and the restoring or the torsional couple of moment m. Now, applying Newton's second law for rotation, the sum of the moment of the external forces acting on the disk is equal to the time derivative of the angular momentum of the disk about delta. Since the moment of inertia of the disk about delta is constant, so d sigma by dt can be written as I theta double prime. where theta double prime is the angular acceleration of the disk. So the moment of the weight plus the moment of the tension plus the moment of the torsional couple is equal to I theta double prime. But the moment of the weight is equal to the moment of the tension is equal to zero, since the weight and the tension are confounded with the axis of rotation delta. Now, substitute the moment of the weight by zero, moment of the tension by zero, and the moment of the restoring or the torsional couple is equal to minus c theta. Then, zero plus zero minus c theta is equal to I theta double prime. Take minus c theta to the right side of this equation, we get I theta double prime plus c theta is equal to zero. Divide both sides by I, we get the differential equation as shown, theta double prime plus c over I theta is equal to zero. Nature of motion. Since the differential equation is of the form of theta double prime plus omega zero squared theta is equal to zero, where omega 0 squared is equal to c over I is a positive constant, therefore the nature of the motion is angular simple harmonic motion, angular since we have rotation. Time equation or solution of the obtained differential equation. The solution of this differential equation has the form of theta equal a sine omega 0 t plus phi, or theta equal a cosine omega 0 t plus phi, where a, omega 0, and phi are constants. The absolute value of a is equal to theta m, which is the amplitude of oscillation, and as you know, theta m is always positive. Since sine omega 0 t plus phi or cosine omega 0 t plus phi varies between minus 1 and the plus 1, we can conclude that theta varies between minus theta m and the plus theta m. Omega 0 is called the angular frequency of the oscillation. Omega 0 t plus phi is called the phase angle of the oscillation. And phi is called the initial phase angle. Omega 0 and omega 0 t plus phi and phi are explained before in one of the preceded videos. So you can watch this video to understand the meaning of these properties.
Let's move to the natural angular frequency. As we have seen in the previous slide, omega 0 is equal to the square root of c over I. Now, this expression shows you that omega 0 is a positive quantity. Recall that the SI unit of omega 0 is the radian per second. Let's move to the natural period. You know that T0 is equal to 2 pi over omega 0. So replace omega 0 by the square root of C over I. This is going to be T0 is equal to 2 pi times the square root of I over C. Recall that the SI unit of the period is the second. Finally, let's move to the natural frequency. You know that F0 is equal to 1 over 2 T0. So if you replace T0 by 2 pi over omega 0, you will get F0 is equal to omega 0 over 2 pi. And finally, the SI unit of the natural frequency is hertz.
Maximum angular speed and maximum angular acceleration. For theta equal theta m sine omega 0 t plus phi, then the angular velocity is the first derivative of the angular abscissa. So theta prime is equal to omega 0 theta m cosine omega 0 t plus phi. As you know, the maximum value of cosine omega 0 t plus phi is equal to 1. Therefore, the maximum value of the angular speed is equal to omega 0 theta m. Therefore, theta m maximum is equal to omega 0 times theta m. Similarly, the angular acceleration is the second derivative of the angular abscissa. So, theta double prime is equal to minus omega 0 squared theta m sine omega 0 t plus phi. Since the maximum value of sine omega 0 t plus phi is equal to 1, therefore the maximum value of the angular acceleration is the absolute value of minus omega 0 squared theta m, since the maximum value of the angular acceleration is always positive. Therefore, the maximum angular acceleration is equal to omega 0 squared theta m. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.